It's like jockeyed whores.
Yeah.
What, are we live now then?
I'm not going to say we're live. Well, given that Jesse Ventura was a politician, are we allowed to make lots of Jesse Ventura quotes?
Depends who Jesse Ventura is.
Do you? You don't know.
Did you need to hand your testicles in at the door?
Maybe.
Do you at least know who Arnold Schwarzenegger is?
I know who Arnold Schwarzenegger is.
Have you seen the film?
You do know. You Red know.
It's that Dutch comedian.
Anyway, so we have to. I mean, I know. We normally talk about nerd stuff, but that election, though.
Well, this is.
We've got to fucking talk about it, don't we? Because who else in Britain is talking about something else that isn't the election? No fucker. So we've got to do it.
So basically, this is a party political broadcast.
No, it isn't.
On behalf of the Game Sandwich Party.
We'll go with that.
Are we a party?
We could be.
Well, there's three of us.
Well, I've got beer. That sort of makes it a party.
Well, three makes a crowd, not a party.
Well, I think you're thinking about party
Stop
in the wrong way.
Naysayer.
I'm having a good time. That makes it a party.
Anyway,
some can have a party of one.
Well. Every night.
All he needs is some baby wet wipes. And an internet connection.
Anyway.
I'm having a fucking party.
Welcome to Game Sandwich. My name's Dwight.
I'm Simon.
I'm Sam and I'm having a party.
I'm going to move this closer, that's what I'm going to do.
Mm-hmm.
Like that.
Now watch as one of us is out of frame, you fucker.
Constantly out of frame.
Well, it's usually Simon, he's in the middle now, so Simon can't be out of frame.
Dwight did that on purpose.
Like a smart person, you see. I put the mirror down here so I can see the back of the cam.
Oh!
Yeah.
Smart as fuck!
I'm not just good looks, you know.
I'm actually amazed by your mirror technology.
Yeah, you see that, so I know we're all in frame. I don't have to scream it through, yeah.
Anyway, that election though,
still don't know who won. I heard Conservatives and Tories. I couldn't get to vote because I was hidden away.
But you do know the Tories and the Conservatives are the same party, right?
As in Conservatives.
No, I thought the Tories and the Lib Dems were.
No, that's what they call a coalition.
Okay.
Right. So
this is going to be a long night.
The Conservatives are called the Tories because it's conservatory.
Is that where they keep all the wicker furniture?
Apparently. Yeah, and they get all their kooky ideas about how to oppress people.
Oppress or impress?
Well, they try to impress people.
Well, a little bit both.
Impress the rich and oppress the poor.
But yeah, so. Well. If you don't mind me asking, how do you vote?
I voted Green Party.
Why did you vote Green Party?
Because I couldn't vote Conservative, because if it hadn't have been for the coalition government, if it hadn't been for the coalition government, everything that they're trying to do now they would have done 5 years ago. I couldn't vote Labour.
Well, they haven't really done anything now because they've only just got into government. Everyone says they're about to do loads of awful things, but this is really a bit unproven.
Okay, so.
Everyone's like they're about to be awful, but I haven't seen any evidence of awful yet.
You haven't let me answer.
I'm only playing devil's advocate.
He asked the question and answered it himself.
Yeah, you're monologuing.
Yeah.
I might be.
We'll get to know his evil plot soon.
Right, so let me ask you this. Would you appoint an equalities minister who is against gay marriage?
I would not. Yeah, no, okay. You've got me there. I would not. And they have. And that seems like an ass backwards fucking.
It depends if he can separate his personal opinion from his business opinion.
Ah, business.
Business.
Ah. It's a good point.
So I couldn't vote Labour because I couldn't vote Miliband because I just didn't like him. and I didn't like what
let's be honest, he does look like Wallace.
Also, Labour pretty much...
he does look so like Wallace.
Labour do come across as more right-wing than a Labour government should be.
Oh, for sure. I mean, ever since their new Labour, they're like this weird centrist party that's sort of like slightly right-wing when they need to be because they want to compete with the Tories.
Yeah.
And...
It's a mismatch that doesn't really work, doesn't
it? Yeah. Yeah, they went from their roots as a like
working for the middle class. Yeah,
no, no, they were like this party that was centred around the unions, around the working man. That's what they're called, Labour, because you're a labourer.
Anyway.
And then they decided, no, more popular, anyway, being a middle class, boring ass party does anything.
Because it sounds like from when they were in the unions and stuff like that, they've listened and changed and moved along with the rest of the world. And the rest of the world are people who were in unions and stuff like that, but are now just 9-to-5ers.
So I didn't vote Liberal Democrat. Well, I didn't vote Tory because, well, for nothing else, the Tories never even came to my house and actually talked to me about their policies. Labour turned up, not to my house, but to my mum's house. And I gave my mum a bunch of questions to ask.
I wish you could got some actual footage of that. Maybe set up a little camera there of Simon's mum asks Labour some questions. That would have been a fucking ace video.
So it was about their humanitarian policies, the policies about the Middle East, policies towards the EU, austerity and all this other crap. And what they basically been pushing leaflets through the doors about was, yeah, we've been cleaning up the streets by going out and picking up rubbish, and we've talked about getting a new crossing. It's like, yeah, so what? So what if you want to get a crossing replaced? What is your position on the national debt and how that affects people moving forward?
But the leaflet that comes through your door is for your local council, not
the same. It's local council and national members of parliament.
They should stand for roughly the same things, but it's got to be different.
They were campaigning on the same thing. So, we didn't see any... the only representatives of Labour...
Absolutely no one came to our house.
Yeah.
So the only representatives we saw were talking about how, you know, they were trying to get some trees planted. Yeah, that's great. But you're a representative of a party that's trying to run the country, and you can't even talk about what you think about what's happening in Syria.
To be fair, I also voted Green, but I did it for reasons that weren't... I actually like the Green Party, because I, to be fair, think they've got as many terrible viewpoints as the other sort of parties, but they're no better than any of the other cunts that are running.
See, I think the Green Party failed because
Well, you say failed. They got over a million votes.
Whereabouts they failed? They failed in branding themselves. I mean, we get it. The Green Party is representative of a whole bunch of stuff. But the person they put forward was this woman. What was her name?
Australian bird.
Yeah.
I thought she was from New Zealand.
Who?
One of the two.
Something about a social faux pas, and then has about as much presence as like a nail in a wall. You know, it's... You're not going to notice it unless you brush against it. So it's pretty much... If they got Russell Brand in there and just gone, pow, that shit would have been...
Oh, he would have fucking killed her.
People don't realise how hard it is to run for government. You're not voting for the people, you're voting for that one representative.
No, I don't know. I didn't...
Why is Boris Johnson still in office?
Because he's fucking hilarious.
People want to see more... When I was
voting in the general election, I didn't vote for personalities, I voted for a party.
Hmm.
And I voted for the Green Party because Not because
nobody had a personality.
No, not because I give a shit about the Green Party, because I wanted to.
You wanted to give them a fair chance against everybody else who was going to get a deliberate.
Because in the constituency that me and Dwight live in, is pretty much a Labour safe seat. Labour, or what Chris Leslie always gets fucking voted in.
I had him say to me the other day, someone should fucking just knock him the fuck out.
You know, I saw a little while ago, there's a house just up the way that's got Chris Leslie posters all over it, and somebody's put little curly mustache on him and a monocle, and then put Chris Leslie throws women under trains like he's like some Dick Dastardly figure. I was like, that is some good fucking graffiti. But anyway, yeah, so we live in a Chris Leslie safe seat, and the only other political party that I've actually seen any posters up for is the Green Party.
Yeah.
And I agree with the Green Party slightly more than Labour. And I think in the way that British politics works, as in your vote isn't counted countrywide, it's only counted in your constituency. Yeah. So if I can vote for the guy that'll probably come second and sort of chuck a spanner in the political works and get in somebody that's not one of the main two parties, then that's a good thing. That was my reasoning.
The only other advertising I've seen around this area is a little bit of UKIP.
Well, it's
right, you know, looking at
get involved, just interrupt him.
Right,
you're monologuing now.
No, I'm not monologuing, I'll shut up and say.
Can you lie?
I looked at the election results for Nottingham East, and UKIP beat the fucking Green Party, and you, like me, have seen all the Green Party things up around the place, and UKIP fucking beat them.
Yeah, do you know why? It's because people believe what's in the newspapers about, we're part of the EU.
So we are part of the
so
EU.
So there's people
coming. Sort of.
There's over a million people have left this country to live and work in Europe. And a load of people have come from the rest of Europe to come live and work here. And they've all been branded as immigrants and that. They're going to take all our jobs. And it's all the fears being fed into.
Taking the jobs.
You know, and it's like, well, Nigel Farage is a very charismatic leader of a bunch of very odd, very,
very... very odd.
Very disturbed individuals.
To be fair, he is a very good party leader. He does do his thing as a figurehead of a party.
He is a
very
brand.
Well.
He's a brand. People want Nigel Farage around because he's hilarious to watch.
Yeah.
How he handles things in the European...
yeah, I can't.
When he turns up.
Well, when he turns up.
I can't fault Farage on.
Forage?
Farage? Nigel Farage? Yeah. I can't fault him.
Garage?
I can't fault him on any of his personal him being him shit, because he does that shit so well.
Yeah.
But he does run a pretty stupid party, really.
Let's face it. Do you deserve to be put into to be given great political power if you run a party that thinks that all of the natural disasters happen because of gays having sex?
I'd forgotten about that. Yeah. However, no, he does deserve to have a lot more MPs because so many people fucking voted for him, and the first boss of the post system is utter horse shite. And, if that many people voted for UKIP, they should have a lot more fucking MPs, just because if we're going to do the democratic system, we should do it fair and not in this weirdly biased system.
It's the rest of England that turns around and goes, I don't want no dirty...
No, we voted on an alternative vote, not proportional representation. They're different. And no, I'm just not going to get. I'm not going to get into that because that is a long conversation. That's
the point I'm going to bring up.
Difficult.
The point I'm going to bring up is, if it becomes the social norm that hating immigrants is the thing,
then fuck you. No, so you're not an immigrant, are you?
Then that becomes the political party that goes in, and everybody's all like, yeah, you know what? They're right. Get rid of the immigrants. And you're the only one who's like, equality for all. That makes you the one in the wrong because you're not following the social norm.
Well, if we've decided,
we've decided as a society
to go with democracy, and the democratically elected party is just like, yeah, we're going to burn children, then the burning children party is what we should all go with.
Well, let's look at it a bit more simply, right? So there was a 66% turnout, and so of that 66%,
it's been the highest for years, hasn't it?
Yeah, but of that 66%, there was enough to just about give the Conservatives a majority in Parliament. Right?
It's not a large one either.
No, so that 34% that weren't engaged, didn't want to have anything to say. Obviously, their voice hasn't been heard, and well, that's their problem, whether they want it to be or not.
Mm.
So we actually look at what the Conservatives want to do, that the majority of that 66% wants to do, and let's say maybe it's actually 33%. Right, so it's just 1% more than everybody else, than everything else combined, right? So it's only a third in that example. The whole voting population, but because only those people turned up, they get it. They want to do all sorts of stuff to do with snooping, invasions of privacy, preventing you to be able to talk to people,
preventing
dating.
Oh, Simon, as like an IT professional, do you want to have a little rant right here about how bullshit the snoopers chart is?
Well.
Do you want to sit forward?
That's yes, you do. So, but go on.
So David Cameron, in his infinite wisdom, has decided that there should be no encryption strong enough that the government cannot break, and so declared that there must be some form of backdoor into encryption so that the government can find out what's been going on.
I can understand it for security
purposes, but that sounds like something.
You get into the point of one person is in charge of everyone when everyone should be in charge of
that
everyone.
That sounds like an idea that on paper is just that sentence. Sounds like something people would vote for in the House of Commons. Now tell us why it's a bad idea.
So,
if the government can't get in, anyone can get in.
So you imagine a couple of hundred thousand dollars worth of computing power, whether it's made from a bunch of PS3s all hooked together or something else, able to figure out what that back door is and then break into it. I don't know, maybe in North Korea, maybe in Saudi Arabia, maybe in China, who knows. Maybe Anonymous, the hacking group, figure it out and publish the private keys or whatever, if it's using PGP on the internet, whatever, it doesn't matter. Some way, somehow, someone figures it out. What does that actually result in? No online purchase you make, whether it's Amazon, Apple, whoever, any kind of online purchase is not secure.
Why don't they just have the government has the same set of encryption keys the business encrypting your shit with?
That does not how it's not how it works.
Okay. I'll shut up. So they've got to encrypt a particular type of way. I mean, the government's going to understand that, but it's going to have a particular set of how it goes through.
So basically, what happens is, if you suspect that somebody's doing something and they're encrypting their information, it has to be able to be decrypted for the other party to be able to see it or read it.
Yeah, so you both got to have... thingy machines in World War One or World War Two, whatever it was.
Oh, you mean the Enigma?
The Enigma machine, yeah.
Yeah, so irrespective of all of that, you have to be able to read what comes back, right? So that means you just do intelligent police work and spy work and all this other stuff, and just ultimately go, right, what's the passwords, what's this, what's that? tell us how to be able to get in. Mm. That's what they want it for. But the actual wording and the scope of what they want to do affects your phone. You know, if you own a modern phone, the file system's encrypted so that if somebody tries to break into your phone, they can't see anything, so they can't get your personal data. They can't break into your bank account. Mm. Online transactions, online access to banks, all this other stuff just goes straight out the window.
This is all solved if everyone becomes government personnel and you have to be...
Well, that's just it, because...
It's also solved if we all ascend to be energy beings made of pure information and never have to interact with a physical computer again, because we are information. Yeah, but shut up.
So the government, right, Cameron has said, this week, obeying the law no longer means that you have nothing to fear from the government. What kind of line is that to say to people?
I don't understand.
That's pretty Inquisition line of thought there. Innocence means nothing.
Whether you can obey the law for the whole of your life, but you still have the government to fear from.
Innocence means nothing.
Okay. Who said that?
The Prime Minister.
This week. And that's what... and that's...
Okay, I wasn't paying attention when you said that line.
And so that's the thin... This whole encryption thing's the thin end of the wedge. So they're talking about making it so if you want to use any kind of social network and they don't like you, they don't like who you associate with, then everything you say has to be vetted by a police officer or an appointed person. But because of austerity and because of privatisation, that will probably be farmed out to a private company for an expensive government contract, like go to Group 4 Security or something like that.
Yup.
And then if you try and fight that, well, I'm sorry, you don't get legal aid anymore, because legal aid was abolished last year, and all of the governments, all of the parties that wanted to bring it back didn't win. So you can't fight, if you're poor, you can't fight in court any ruling made against you because legal aid doesn't exist anymore, unless there's some kind of evidence to do with abuse or something similar. So you can't fight your own corner. So you could be victimised by the police, controlled by the police, have all of your electronic communications controlled. You can't fight it in the courts because you can't afford and then you can't get a job.
Or even go to the courts without you being there.
They can even try you without you even having to go to court.
Oh, well, that's been a thing for ages because, seriously, admission here, I've had loads of council tax rulings against me where I've not bothered to actually turn up to the hearing that was in court. I went to one and decided...
Yeah, but if you were invited and you didn't go, that's your own business.
I was invited to all of them. I went to one, I decided... the rest of them are going to just be the same as this.
No, it's different to that, though, because there was a high-profile case about 2 years ago where undercover police were getting into relationships with women and stuff like that.
This sounds and totally having, sketchy.
And getting them pregnant and that kind of thing. And it was decided that you should be able to try people without them being in court to protect the other parties involved, but the way the law was apparently written, was that it just basically said you can be tried in court without ever knowing that you're going to court, without ever knowing what the evidence is against you, and not being able to represent yourself because there's no scope of limitations.
Mm.
So you can be tried and convicted, not know, and then have your life controlled. You are then, if this new charter comes in, you are not allowed to tell people that you are the result of all of this.
And that sounds very sketchy.
And it's just like, seriously?
It's all starting to pile into one sort of...
Yeah, complete steam pile of bullshit.
Mm.
And then, anyway... Right, so who saw the austerity riots reported on last week? Were they actually properly reported on?
To be fair, I didn't really look at any proper news outlets about her.
Riots and marches happen all over the country, all over the time.
Because I don't know,
and they do not get reported.
I mostly didn't look because I knew people that were there, so I had first-hand information about her. So I didn't really think to actually try and look at actual information from news outlets.
So right, so you think about it. So you've got this government that set up this kind of position. Now the previous government, Labour, they introduced a whole bunch of shit to do with tuition fees and a whole bunch of other stuff, which I've had too much beer to remember. But that one pissed me off because it's like, why are you charging people to be educated?
Yeah. What? It's like rich people selling their last bits of information before they die just so they can make a quick buck out of the new generation that needs to understand
and learn it. Just going back to the austerity marches and stuff. So, I have been invited by some friends who, like I said, were at the other austerity marches to go to one that is on the date of the opening of Parliament to march against the new government because they are unhappy with how the democratic process that we have currently elected its leaders. And I am of two minds as to whether to go, because I don't like it either, because I think that the democratic process that we have at the moment is entirely rigged. Well, I know it's entirely rigged in favour of the two biggest parties. Of course it fucking is, look at it. But at the same time, well, if we had proportional representation, we still would have had a very fucking similar outcome, except it would have been a coalition government between the Conservatives, which we have anyway, and UKIP, which is just the Conservatives with added crazy. So it wouldn't have made it any nicer for us. But it would have made it fairer. I would have preferred it. It would have made it fairer. But
no,
none of these people that are marching against it would have liked it anymore.
No, but the march is about austerity, not votes, isn't it?
Oh, no, yeah. Well, if it is...
Austerity?
As in government cutting back on social issues and stuff, right, to save money because of financial crisis disease.
Right. So the
people paying for the
right. So the government, a government pays a certain amount of money into the International Monetary Fund, and there's a big fund and everything else.
Mm.
And the government also then borrows money to be able to do what it needs to do, and then it raises money through taxes and or selling national assets.
Okay.
And so that's the financial workings of a government in a really, really basic sense. So when a government wants to borrow money, right, it has a credit rating, much like anybody else.
Yeah.
And that's where this agency, Standard & Poor's, talks about a country losing its AAA rating and stuff like that. So the government borrows in the form of what they call bonds, if I remember rightly. This is from memory, so anyone who's listening, who's still listening and hasn't switched off. If I'm wrong, whatever. And that allows them to set an interest rate for the amount of money that they borrow.
Okay.
And then they pay it back. So when the government says that it is paying down the debt, everybody thinks, oh, right, well, the national debt's 150 billion and they've got it down to 90 billion. That's great. What they don't realise is that it's the rate at which they're increasing the overdraft, not the overdraft itself. So you could be £1,000 in debt with your bank, and you're spending more money than you make, right? So your overdraft is increasing by £100 a month.
Okay.
And then you say, well, I'm paying down my overdraft. And what you're doing is reducing your expenses so that instead of your overdraft increasing by £100 a month, it's increasing by £80 a month. But your overdraft is still getting bigger.
Okay, all right.
And that's what the government's doing.
Got it, yeah.
But they're saying that they're paying down the debt. No, what they're doing is they're decreasing the rate at which the overdraft is going up.
Okay. Well, this all seems like...
So eventually it will stop going up because of the numbers.
Yeah, but they said that that would happen by this...
Why don't we all just take a hit and pay 40% tax?
Who do we even owe it to?
It would be the banks. Who do you think lends it to the country? We borrow money in the form of bonds from other countries or from
banks. We borrow it from privatised
third parties. Is it mostly at this point, sorry, because I don't know.
Right, I'm about
is
to tell
it,
you.
Is it at this point mostly other countries or mostly...
It depends on who's got the money. So think of America. Think of America, right? America, a lot of its debt is financed by China. Mm-hmm. 40% of, roughly 40% of... If the figure I saw is true, and it might not be, but if it is, up to, 40% of corporate America is owned by China.
That's very interesting.
And America is able to service its $15 trillion debt by doing clever things with the exchange rate and everything else. But it's only, what, last summer or the summer before, where they had to close down... the working government of America for a couple of days to save some money and send everybody home without
that, pay. I didn't think that was for a couple of money. I think that was because there was
a technically legal loophole or something.
Technically
in power, so nobody
could. That was a vote on increasing the government's overdraft. And because the decision didn't get made by the House of Senators, no decision was made, so no more money was available until a decision could be made.
I thought that it was because people disagreed with other people, and thus one side threw a hissy fit and told everyone to not go to work for a bit.
No.
I don't know, I'm a bit shaky on American politics.
I just told you what it was.
Going back to the thing you said earlier, about
Hi guys that are on the internet, if any of you are American and can inform us how this works,
reach us at our Twitter handle at game_sandwich.
And if you think I'm full of shit, that's fine because I don't care. Yeah.
But going back to what you said earlier, the way it's set up, Parliament is set up.
It's fucking set up.
With the way it's done, there's another way that's just been thought up of, which is digital democracy. And basically, you vote per person that goes in to each and every job instead of one party.
Right,
and
that sounds quite
complicated.
Can I ask you a question? Right. So, if you already vote for local government, okay, what is the relevance in your MP coming from your area? Would it not make more sense? Would it not make more sense, right, if that you had 1,000 seats, for example, or even 100? You had 100 seats in Parliament, because that's an easy number. And then if 34% of the vote went to Labour, they got 34 seats in Parliament. And it was up to the leader to appoint those 34 people. The remaining 33.
That's how it works, isn't it?
No.
No. Okay.
And if you voted for 20... If 26% of the nation voted for UKIP, whether you like them or not, they got 26 seats in government because there's 100 seats. And if 55% of the people voted for... I know the maths have gone beyond 100 now, I'm doing examples. If 55% of the nation voted for Conservatives, they would have 55 seats. So whatever the direct percentage of the vote is, that's how many seats you get in government. And it's irrelevant as to where that person comes from. Because why...
This actually sounds like a good idea.
Who picks the seats then?
Well, it's
the electorate.
It's done on regions, which is why the SNP, they've got way less people but more seats in government because of the regions.
Yeah, which is bullshit, really, isn't it?
Well, not necessarily for the Scottish. The Scottish might disagree
I disagree with them. Come at me, Scotland.
but the point is... Right,
throw Scotch eggs at him out the window.
So if you've got 100... There's like, I don't know, let's say there's 50 million people who can vote, right? And what there was like 2 million people voted for for Green Party.
Mm.
They should have 2 seats in Parliament if there was 100 seats.
Okay.
Plain and simple. It's easy.
Yeah,
so everybody can understand that.
Why didn't it happen?
Because that's not how it works.
I'm trying to ask why it worked. Well,
does it work? Right, so you get different...
That's what I was under the thinking
right,
of.
Okay.
What was that?
You get areas that are constituencies.
Like Nottingham North, Nottingham South, okay. And Nottingham East.
Right, in each area, everybody votes.
Mm.
For a candidate, there are many candidates on the ballot. You can vote for one of them.
Mm.
Right, the one that gets the most votes in each area, in each constituency, gets that constituency.
And then becomes a member of parliament.
Yeah.
For that constituency, because they are then considered to represent the people in that area.
Okay, and that person then gets a seat in the House of Parliament.
Yes. Yes.
However, the person that may choose to stand for that area, that constituency, doesn't have to live there. Doesn't even never have to visit
the area. I don't mind about that, as long as he understands the area.
But that's the point.
No. And the person that gets the party that gets the most votes, not person, because the person says, I'm part of this party. So, you're voting for a local guy that is, let's say, one of the chaps around here. I'm voting for him. I'm voting for, let's say, Seb Saw, even though he wasn't part of a party. He is a local independent guy. Gentleman that he is. If he was part of a party, I vote for him. And then the party, amongst itself, says who's actually the Prime Minister.
Out of the ones that have been picked recently?
No.
Okay.
Out of anyone they damn well feel like.
Right, so we don't get a choice on the Prime Minister.
On who's the Prime Minister? No, we do not.
If I may, Tony Blair got in after John Major was kicked out, right? Mm. And then Tony Blair quit.
Mm.
And so Gordon Brown...
And just said Gordon Brown lead now. Bye.
Shut up. So...
Lols, bye.
So Gordon Brown went from Chancellor of the Exchequer to Prime Minister and stayed in power. But nobody voted for him. So he was an undemocratically elected leader of the country. He was making decisions on behalf of everybody, but nobody had voted him in.
So basically, the only problem we've got at a minute is we've done one round of voting, and that's it, we've got a Prime Minister from that, only basically voting on what it is.
David Cameron could get hit by a bus tomorrow. Whether that would happen or not, I don't know. That's not a conspiracy.
Let's hit him with a bus.
And then someone else in the Conservative Party, they would have a leadership election. So someone else would eventually replace him because they'd be a party political...
Yeah, they'd have a party election thingy.
And then he'd just go. Someone new again.
Also, please, can we just hit him with a bus?
No.
Car?
No.
Plane?
I'm not allowed to say anything because I want to go to America, and if they were like, you're diddly about the Prime Minister, what are you going to be all about the President? I'm like, I just want to go look at Disneyland.
We're not talking about hitting Obama with a bus. Unless
no, we're not.
No, what?
Obama was in the same car as David Cameron. No, that would be madness.
Anyway.
Well, no, because... Basically, you just end up with a whole new kind of crazy.
I'm having my freedoms of speech impaired on by the fact that I can't say particular things because I want to go to Disneyland with my niece.
Yeah, so shut up.
Yeah, because fuck America.
I have no comment on that.
No comment.
Yeah, okay. Hey there, internet.
I have no recollection of what Sam's just said.
I could not condone.
Fully expect to be edited here.
No, I'm not. That's not. No, I'm just gonna leave it in. That's fine. There's no slam. There's no Sam Dunk for you there.
Yeah, politicians ain't shit.
That's fine. That's all good.
Bitches ain't shit.
Oh, you had to go there.
Anyway. Well, it's my fucking catchphrase. Apparently.
I can't remember what you say.
So the basic premise of a government is to perpetuate itself. Mm. If you accept
that... Are we going full Dune here?
No, no. Think about it. All of the activities of a government are ultimately designed to perpetuate itself and convince the electorate that it is doing just enough, that it's doing a good enough job, that it should stay in power.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Bob.
That's it. Whether it's Labour or Tories or whoever, they're all still in the Houses of Parliament making an effective or ineffective government, depending on your perspective. But the government is perpetuating itself.
Yeah.
And so that's what they are trying to do. They are just trying to keep themselves where they are. And that's what they exist for, and that is their sole purpose. And to get as rich as possible while they do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
What? Dwight, mm. If you had have voted, if you had have been in the city...
I don't know what the choices were on the ballot.
Would you vote for me?
I was in a bungalow in the middle of nowhere.
No.
Yeah, but if you had been in the city...
If I stood for Nottingham, would you vote for me?
I don't know what your policies are.
My policies are...
Are we going to break down the whole of your governmental...
Before would he vote for you? Right. So, the choices, as I remember them, on the Nottingham East electoral ballot were... Labour, Tories, Green, UKIP, and two independents, one of them being Seb Saw. Hi, Seb. He was the one that actually sent us a leaflet. The other guy didn't, so I don't know anything about it. Hi, other guy. You should actually send out a thing saying what you want us to believe in.
Anyway, I don't know what the difference between an independent and a party candidate is.
Well, one of them has a bunch of guys around them. An independent
is a party
does not have any other guys.
Okay, now I know that. I'm going to slice the two independents off the ballot because I wouldn't vote for them.
Why not?
Because if you got to the point where you're trying to be elected and you haven't got somebody next to you who you can rely on, that speaks a little bit to me about...
Okay, fair enough.
Not being able to push your ideals onto somebody or just show your ideals to someone and have them go, I like that, I'm going to put some effort and time in and come with you.
It's partly because when you stand for a vote for Parliament, you have to pay a deposit.
Per party member?
Per
seat you're standing in.
He's only standing in one seat. That doesn't matter. The amount of people he's got around him.
No. So you have to find someone else who's willing, who not only believes in what you say, is willing to put some money into it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, each of those independent candidates had to put up 500 quid.
And is that all it is? 500 quid?
It's 500 quid.
Why don't we all fucking go for it?
Broke as shit. If you want to, next election...
Simon's on about...
Fucking... Chuck up 500 quid and I think it might be 5%.
And have a party.
It's either 5 or 10%.
The sandwich party. Go on.
It's either 5 or 10%. If you don't get that back, then you don't get your deposit back.
Okay.
It's to pay for people like laughing at how many votes you didn't get.
I'm not fully sure on all the policies each of those ones had.
But you get the general gist of the parties. So if you had have been around and not away for work, who would you have voted for? And why?
Did Tories have anything to do with the all the spy shit and the...
Yes.
Right. I think
Labour made it possible for various lucrative parts of the NHS to go out to private tender. The Tories,
both of the big two, are cunts, and
allegedly
that's pretty much undeniable.
It's undeniably allegable. allegedly undeniable.
I think I would have either voted for... I would have voted Greens. I wouldn't vote Tories. I don't think I would vote Independent.
Go with the why you wouldn't have each of these. You wouldn't vote Greens cause...
I wouldn't vote Greens because they don't understand how to do politics.
That's actually pretty fair, like
having good ideas is fantastic.
No. That's
having
pretty good fair. Ideas we can just move on.
Yeah.
They pretty much don't. That's fair.
Yeah.
You wouldn't vote Tories cause...
I wouldn't vote Tories... I don't mind the fact that the people that have put in effort to make money want to not have to lose all their money, basically. If you've worked hard for your entire existence and then have to pay 50% tax because you earn over a certain amount, I'm kind of like...
You feel for them,
yeah.
But...
I think it should be a line all the way up. So you earn a certain amount, it stays at the same line.
Yeah, okay, but you wouldn't vote from cause...
Of their inability to adapt to a modern style of living.
Okay.
And encompass that in their policies.
All right. You wouldn't vote for other people because, carry on, you wouldn't vote for independence because...
I wouldn't vote for independence because I think you need a bit more of an idea of how you're going to go about shit.
They're just, you're just some asshat that's just decided to put up some money and...
Yeah.
And
if you've got like 10 people around him and that independent's got 10 people next to him...
To be fair, they've each got to have a little bit of a fucking...
They've got to, yeah.
They've got to have
they
a few people
just doing
around.
It all by themselves.
Yeah, they're not doing it out their bedroom, dude.
But he's an independent. He hasn't got a name on his thing. He's not branded. He doesn't understand the fact that he's selling himself as a minister.
Fair enough. All right, carry on.
Which leaves with Conservatives, Labour and... Liberal Democrats. UKIP, an SNP.
SNP's in Scotland, don't they?
Okay. Yeah, and but they. Sorry, no, I'm not going to talk about the SNP. Carry on.
Lib Dems,
I have things to say about them, but not now.
Lib Dems, I've got no idea about. It's like one of those policies that's fallen between the cracks every time someone's gone up and gone, oh yeah, but I've heard about this electrical standard or something like that, and everyone's goes, yeah, it's Labour, Conservatives, and Tories. I'm like, so who the fuck are Lib Dems? What do? They just, to me, I've heard nothing about them, so they just sit there like a wedge under the door and all this shit's flooding in.
Wow.
I don't know about Lib Dems.
This is, okay, carry on.
Conservatives and Labour, basically, were the main two.
How about UKIP? What's your feelings on UKIP?
Just not ever. If at any point you judge somebody by the ground under their feet, you are incredibly thick. You have failed at being able to exist on this planet. I mean, personally, if I was going to Parliament, one of my policies would be all people must be born, must be terra firma, born.
What?
We must be born on Earth before venturing out into space.
Well, that's not really a...
Solely because...
An issue right now.
It's not an issue right now, but the point is, it's something for the future.
Can I make a point on that? Is that right?
Go on.
You asked me about if I stood for Parliament, what my policy would be, and because you mentioned UKIP, it would actually be in direct contravention of what UKIP have been saying.
Mm.
And that I believe that universal healthcare is a basic human right.
I don't think anybody's got unique human rights.
I do.
I don't think anybody's entitled to anything ever in the history of anything ever. Your entire existence has been one giant, at the minute, streak of luck. And you're here with the rest of us.
Are you?
And we decided as a group a long time ago to work together to stay alive.
No,
I don't mind you having healthcare, as long as we all get healthcare equally.
Right, which is what I just said.
Yeah, I'm pretty
yeah,
much...
Yeah, but you put it down as a human right thing, as you get it whether you need it or not.
No. That's your interpretation.
Okay. All right. No, my interpretation, yeah. Go on.
Yeah. So basically, if you think about the sum of human effort over the last 5,000, 10,000 years has reached us to this technological point that we stand at now. Now, the fact that we all live in separate countries and speak separate languages and all point our missiles at each other or not, depending on the case, as the case may be, we have reached a point where we have a certain fundamental understanding of nutrition, health...
How to be a human. How to exist as a human being on this planet.
Yeah, and how to look after ourselves and other people around us.
Yeah.
But what we do then is we try and control that and say, I will heal you, but I will not heal you.
Mm.
I will feed you, but I will not feed you. And it's like, well, that's a very basic, immature perspective because he's saying, this is mine and you can't have any. So it's like, you walk...
But that's the point. It's down to the people that...
No, walk along a street, right? You walk along a street and you see someone who's in dire need of medical assistance. And then you start to apply first aid and then you find out that they were an illegal immigrant in this country. And you go, oh... Sorry, I can no longer apply any kind of medical aid towards you because you don't deserve it because you haven't contributed to this country anymore.
I think
that's fucked up.
What, seriously?
If someone needs medical treatment for whatever disease anything else, they should get it. But that's the point. You've got political parties like UKIP that are saying, no, you shouldn't.
Hey, but guys,
going back to what I was talking about.
Guys, right, so... Human rights, the rights to all these things, they are only there because they are given to us by the powerful in society. We don't innately have them because the people that are powerful in society could shit all over us at any point. Because they could just shit all over us at any point because they've got more power than we do. However,
how have they got more power than you?
No.
Because they can because they can fucking pay people to do shit for them. And shut up, I'm not done making my point. But the fact that we all actually respect these things that don't technically have to be respected because the powerful in society
could just for thousands of years
could just fuck all over it, but the fact that we do respect it is a good thing and we should keep doing it.
Respecting ideals is fine, I ain't got a problem with that.
Yes,
the ideal that you've put yourself in a position where you've worked hard enough to become someone in society that people look to and have a voice of opinion that people listen to is one of these people that are powers of the society, whatever it was you were calling them.
Now
there are ways to get to that point. You can either through money, through knowledge, or through people that you know, networking. But that doesn't necessarily mean that that's the right way of going about things.
So, if I may, whether you take a human right as something that's been afforded to you or not is... a little bit jaded in one sense. The fact that someone can take something away from you does not necessarily mean that the thing that you had is a construct that was afforded to you by that person in power in the first place. So if you have a basic human right to freedom of persecution and then you are persecuted by a government body, that does not mean that the freedom of persecution is a construct created by the government that they take away. It is something that they have chosen to ignore and abuse you with. That's different.
A very interesting argument that could be argued by people that are a lot cleverer at arguing than us for a long fucking time. I think that would be interesting to hear that argument.
Right, so just to explain what I said for you, right? So you as an individual, you as a human being, you wake up tomorrow and you go to work and stuff. It is your right as a law-abiding, ordinary, working human being...
That day of job off and go to the fucking pub. Go to Spoons. Go to Curry Club.
Is to not be persecuted by anybody.
Go get a cheeky Nando's.
Not to be, interrogated or to be accused of being associated with something and then be tortured for it or anything else. It is your human right as an ordinary human being not to be persecuted.
Chinandos.
Isn't persecuted just a like I was saying, hated for a reason?
Well, hated for a spurious reason, hated for a made-up reason, hated for a reason that doesn't even exist because people are bored.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, so if then somebody in a government body decides that they are going to persecute you, that hasn't removed your right to not be persecuted. They have chosen to ignore it.
Okay.
So if somebody decides that they're going to torture you because they want some information out of you.
Yeah, yeah.
Whether you're associated with whatever information they need or not, right? They are starting to persecute you,
They've
ignored your human right. It's not that they gave you that human right and then took it away, which is what Sam's argument is. My argument is that you always had that human right and they chose to ignore it and abuse it.
Okay.
And I think that human right applies to life and liberty.
I don't know if that is my argument.
And that's what you said.
It sort of is. No. I think that you always have that liberty and those rights. But what I'm saying is you should be glad every day that a government that you live under decides to actually respect those rights instead of just walking to
a government.
Home.
Is just a bunch of people.
It is a bunch
elected
of,
in place,
not necessarily elected.
Well, put in place.
But you should be glad every day that people don't fucking stomp into your home and fucking conscript you to an army.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Be glad of that. Don't bitch when something slightly off doesn't go your way.
Well, no, yeah, but what you're saying is because things aren't a lot worse than they are, if things are a little bit bad but not worse, then you shouldn't complain because they could be a lot worse. That's bullshit.
Yeah.
That's basically saying, yeah,
you've got a knock at the door, by the way, there.
Just because we only punched you in the face a little bit, you shouldn't complain because we could have cut your arm off. That's bullshit.
Okay, I see what you're saying there.
Alright. Why I would vote for whoever's on the East Midlands ballot and stuff like that.
Yeah. Who would you have actually voted for then?
To be honest, I think I would have tossed the vote.
You would have just
I'm of the mind of
you would have drawn a big old dick on that and spoiled the ballot.
Yeah, but that doesn't get counted, so it doesn't count to your
deck. No, it does.
No, it doesn't.
No, they count.
No, it gets voided. It gets voided, and it counts as a vote, but it doesn't count as a vote to anyone.
It doesn't get counted for anything. That's why people are campaigning for the none of the above. That's why they want the extra slot on the ballot paper that says, I am voting, I am making a democratic choice.
No,
that democratic choice is for no one above.
Yeah.
They don't count spoiled ballots as towards the overall voting thing. You don't see...
Really?
No, I thought they did. No, yeah. That's why I've just said it like six times. They don't count it.
But either way,
you don't see the statistics where it goes 26% this party, 26% this party, 48% nobody liked what the fuck these guys are doing and you should all sort
of
tell.
Okay, I thought they did. And
no, they don't.
That's one of the big arguments. This is rocking my world because I thought that they did count spoiled ballots as a thing.
They don't. Mm.
Right, okay, fair enough.
We need a none of the above box.
Well, we obviously do, since this is a thing that I thought was a thing, but it isn't.
I'm of a mind that you walk into a cake shop and all they've got is shitty
cake.
Shitty scones that have gone off from 3 weeks ago.
Delicious scones.
And I want cake.
Cake.
And all the
scones.
Choices are shitty scones. I'm just not going to pick it. I'm just going to turn around and walk out that shop. That's the choice. I'm not going to pick a shitty scone and be sad about having a shitty scone. I wanted a cake. I didn't get a cake. Tough titties for me.
Yeah, and you want to.
We've got a big room full of shitty scones, and everyone's having a fucking cry.
That's a very good fucking.
If you don't like it, say something.
I like your fucking metaphor for the entire.
At which point, I shouldn't have walked out.
I
shouldn't have walked out the shop for not getting a cake. I should have turned around and gone, "Which one of you fuckers have got my cake?
Yes.
One of you's got a cake in here, and I want it. I will come back there and make this cake myself if needs be. I will dedicate 100% of my life to making this fucking cake, and I will enjoy this cake, and we will all have cake. If you offer me shitty scone again, we're going to have a fucking problem.
The Conservatives and Labour are scone here, aren't they?
Yeah.
Everyone else is scone.
They're all stale, week-old scones.
Mm-hmm.
Even Seb. Seb was scone.
Seb's gone.
Seb's gone.
Yeah. That's my opinion on voting.
Is scone. Are we done here?
I think we're done here. If there's anything we haven't wrapped up or anything like that, just give it a shout and go, what was your opinion on this? Chuck it up on the Facebook page.
Seriously, tell us.
One of us would.
Tell us why we're wrong.
Yeah.
Because we're wrong and you know it. Tell us why we're wrong.
We're right and your butt hurt. But we want to know it.
Fuck you.
Anyway.
Fuck you. Now tell me why I shouldn't be telling you to go fuck your mum.
Wow, that's one way to end that.
Well, that is how I end everything.
What, by demanding people to know why they won't fuck your mum?
By putting cake on the floor.
That's some wrong cake there, dude.
Anyway.
My cake is the best cake.
This has been a game sandwich. Bring
all of the girls this
has been a game sandwich political party broadcast. Sponsored by cake.
So you never answered whether you'd vote for me or not.
Oh, we'd vote for you as mayor.
I'd vote for you because I know you, yeah. But I don't know. If I didn't know you, and I'd be like, I need to see some policies there, chap.
Yeah, I could do policies.
Oh yeah, no.
I've heard one of them. Get the website up together and get those policies.
Yeah, you've already heard one of them.
Yeah.
Anyway, game sandwich, politics,
Facebook,
cake, Facebook, fuck your mum, love you.
No, Sam,
don't ever leave me.
Sam.
Bye.
Sam.
First of all, what went through my mind is how stupid am I to actually volunteer for this. It was unbelievably painful.